Welcome back to Living 808. Fun stuff. Fia and Johnny Sweet hit the stage this past weekend to come together for the people in Kalihi. Here with the details about noise from the towers, we have Ty Tamagawa, Bradley Anagaran, and Ponesawan Wheeler, and this is all part of our good news story. Love that. Thank you guys so much for being here. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Let me ask you, Ty, first. Yes. Who are the Pillars, and why did you start this whole thing?
Yeah, so the mission statement for the Pillars is pretty much, you know, we want to represent God to the fullest capacity by loving communities globally, pioneering change, innovatively connecting with people, and inspiring the world to make the impossible possible. Pretty much, essentially, like 10 years ago, we're strangers.
Yeah.
And then, but we all had strong desires to pretty much, you know, make the world a better place. By happenstance, God put us together. We said, this is our people. We ran with it. And we do, you know, a lot of stuff. We do community events, obviously, organization, advocacy, media projects. And yeah, it's just been a wild ride from, you know, from what we've been doing to here. And, you know, we just, yeah, as far as, you know, why the Pillars was happening, pretty much, it's simply as God told us to do it, pretty
much.
Yeah,
you're called to do it.
Yeah, the core of the Pillars pretty much is, if Jesus was here, you know, what would he be doing? And how would he be loving, you know, this person, this city, this state, this nation, whatsoever? That's pretty much us in a nutshell.
Strong men of faith joining us right here on Living 808 Live. The Pillars recently held a concert. It was called Noise from the Towers. You got a couple of really strong men of God in that concert as well. Tell me about the concert and how it came about.
So it's actually kind of a crazy story. It started off with our first project, which is a banquet. Mm-hmm. We invited different housing projects to that. And I met this guy named Johnny King. Shout out to Johnny King, by the way. And he approached us. He's like, hey, you got to meet this guy named Dez because he's also community-minded. We feel like if you put you guys together, it'd be great. So I met with Dez. We chopped it up a bit. And I started to say, hey, I got this idea for a concert in KPT.
Yeah.
And he was like, KPT?
Yeah, I'm sure there were some
questions. Yeah. but props to him for seeing the vision. And I just wanted to be in KPT because I felt like that's what Jesus wanted to be at.
Yeah.
So pretty much, you know, it started off super small. Like, we're thinking about a Matson truck. Uh-huh. With some local artists on it, some speakers, and just, you know, rocking it out in the parking lot. But then it started to get larger because Dez was like, hey, I have some connection with Fia. And then ever since then, it snowballed and snowballed. And it's like God took this small idea and made it kind of more his size, pretty much.
That's really awesome.
Yes.
And this is a community that probably needed it more than they even knew.
Yeah, no, I mean, there's a lot of moving parts, government politics, business, you know, street politics, all that kind of stuff.
Absolutely.
But it was great.
Ponesawan, tell us a little bit about Noise from the Towers and the feedback that you got from the community.
Well, the feedback we got back was incredibly amazing, positive. People from all different project housings were basically over there. And it sparked a new thing for other different communities and other places, specifically in Waianae, which I'm a Waianae boy, Waianae graduate.
Oh, Westside.
Westside.
Shout out, Westside.
Westside inside the house. And just the ball that they got rolling in regards to trying to do community work and just get things happening that have never happened before.
Wow, you guys are real, I can tell you guys are led. This is awesome. Brad, let's talk about what's next for Pillars, because you got some events coming up.
Yeah, so currently right now, we're actually working on creating a master plan regarding the redevelopment of the Sand Island Recreational Area. Not too long ago, we were actually working with Representative Ganadin regarding a bill that involved that development process over that area. Mm-hmm. And the main emphasis being, you know, the Kalihi community as well as Native Hawaiians being the main stakeholders for what they get to say gets built in that particular area. So anybody who's listening, if you guys have any connections with any of that, you know, if you could get that through to us, because right now it's got passed over to Representative Holt right now.
Yeah.
And that bill is actually passed as well, but it's sitting in the Department of Budget and Finance, and it's just pending funds and approval. So we're just kind of waiting right now. You know, if anybody could get that through to us, I mean, it's going to bless the community immensely. On top of that, though, besides the point, you know, we do want to throw other major events and activities in these other housing projects. Mm-hmm. So we're also looking for sponsors for anybody who's able to help out with that. But we also do, you know, little mini projects here and there, different community activities here and there in different neighborhoods. But I think one of the coolest ones that we actually do is this thing called Breaking Bread, where we actually go into different families and houses and we actually cook gourmet meals for individual families. You know,
that's
just one of those cool things, you know, like you sit down at a family table, you ask a bunch of questions, you know, just something that you don't typically get to see very often.
Very cool. I like that.
But yeah, I mean, go to our YouTube channel. You know, we have a bunch of projects that we're going to be releasing pretty soon. And I think even more so just to encourage other people who are watching, you know, if you have ideas that you want to do as well, you know, feel free to reach out to us. Feel free to get people together and do something.
Leads me to my next question. You weren't quite on your knees begging for help, but because you asked for some public help, this is a great time to ask for some support from our Living 808 viewers. How do we go about helping you out, and how can we find out more information?
Simply just follow our Instagram, more so subscribe to our YouTube. You know, we have a lot of our media projects that are about to go in there. The faster we monetize this kind of stuff, you know, the faster we can get, you know, this as a full-time job. I mean, right after this, I gotta go work already.
Yeah.
But, you know, but we have a lot of great ideas
for
Hawaii.
Me too, by the way.
We have a lot of great ideas for Hawaii. We want to do this full-time because our hearts is ready to bless the community. And also, if you want to donate on our website, mm-hmm. you know, there's a donation as well. But, and yeah, quick shout out just to, there's other organizers that couldn't be here today, but we got Vessi, we got Dez with Formula Records, Limited Addiction. And we also have Annie Peterson with Better Tomorrows. These like core people. Without them, this would not have happened. Derek also with security. And Mountain View Community Church, Mondo Grande's Missionary Church, Christ Embassy, and Keiki Oka'aina. They had donated stuff. And last but not least, the Credit Hacker, owned by Scott Kobayashi. You know, they're the only business that donated money to us. So huge blessing. Go check them out on Instagram if you're planning trips, because he can save you lots of money.
Appreciate the shout outs. Thank you guys for being here.
Thank you. Aloha. Thank you for having us.
And we want to remind everybody that Good News is brought to you by Called Church. You can check them out at calledchurch.org or join them on Sunday services held at Moanalua High School at 8:30 a.m. and 10 a.m. All right, coming up,